हेलो एवरीवन, आज हम क्लास 12 केमिस्ट्री एनसीईआरटी की बुक से यूनिट 10 हेलो अल्केन्स एंड हेलो एरीन्स का रीडिंग करेंगे। ये एक ऑडियो बुक है रिवीजन पर्पस के लिए। अगर आपको बुक्स बाय करनी है तो लिंक मैंने डिस्क्रिप्शन में दे रखे हैं। हेलोजिनेटेड कंपाउंड्स परसिस्ट इन द एनवायरमेंट ड्यू टू द रेजिस्टेंस टू ब्रेक डाउन बाय सॉइल बैक्टीरिया। द रिप्लेसमेंट ऑफ हाइड्रोजन एटम्स इन एन एलिफेटिक और एरोमेटिक हाइड्रोकार्बन बाय हेलोजन एटम्स results in the formation of alkyl halide in bracket haloalkane and aryl halide in bracket haloarine respectively. Haloalkanes contain halogen atoms attached to the sp3 hybridized carbon atom of an alkyl group, whereas haloarenes contain halogen atoms attached to sp2 hybridized carbon atoms of an aryl group. Many halogen containing organic compounds occur in nature and some of these are clinically useful. These classes of compounds find wide applications in industry as well as in day-to-day life. They are used as solvents for relatively non-polar compounds and as starting materials for the synthesis of wide range of organic compounds. Chlorine-containing antibiotic chloramphenicol produced by microorganisms is very effective for the treatment of typhoid fever. Our body produces iodine-containing hormone thyroxine, the deficiency of which causes a disease called goiter. Synthetic halogen compounds, namely chloroprene, is used for the treatment of malaria. Halothane is used as an anesthetic during surgery. Certain fully fluorinated compounds are being considered as potential blood substitutes in surgery. In this unit, you will study the important methods of preparation, physical and chemical properties, and uses of organohalogen compounds. 10.1 classification. 10.1.1 on the basis of number of halogen atoms. Haloalkanes and haloarenes may be classified as follows. This may be classified as mono, di, or polyhalogen. In bracket, tri, tetra, etc. compounds depending on whether they contain one, two or more halogen atoms in their structures. For example, monohaloalkane, dihaloalkane, trihaloalkane. Monohaloarene, dihaloarene, trihaloarene. Monohalo compounds may further be classified according to the hybridization of the carbon atom to which the halogen is bonded as discussed below. 10.1.2 compounds containing sp3 carbon X bond, where X is equals to fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine. A. Alkyl halides or haloalkanes in bracket are X. In alkyl halides, the halogen atom is bonded to an alkyl group R. They form a homologous series represented by CnH2n+1X. They are further classified as primary, secondary or tertiary according to the nature of carbon to which halogen is attached. If halogen is attached to a primary carbon atom in an alkyl halide, the alkyl halide is called primary alkyl halide or primary alkyl halide. Similarly, if halogen is attached to secondary or tertiary carbon atom, the alkyl halide is called secondary alkyl halide and tertiary alkyl halide respectively. Primary, secondary and tertiary. B. Allylic halides. These are the compounds in which the halogen atom is bonded to an sp3 hybridized carbon atom adjacent to carbon-carbon double bond, that is to an allylic carbon. C. Benzylic halides. These are the compounds in which the halogen atom is bonded to an sp3 hybridized carbon atom attached to an aromatic ring. 10.1.3 compounds containing sp2 carbon halogen bond. This class includes A. Vinylic halides. These are the compounds in which the halogen atom is bonded to a sp2 hybridized carbon atom of a carbon-carbon double bond. B. Aryl halides. These are the compounds in which the halogen atom is directly bonded to the sp2 hybridized carbon atom of an aromatic ring. 10.2. Nomenclature. Having learned the classification of halogenated compounds, let us now learn how these are named. The common names of alkyl halides are derived by naming the alkyl group followed by the name of halide. In the IUPAC system of nomenclature, alkyl halides are named as halosubstituted hydrocarbons. For monohalogen substituted derivatives of benzene, common and IUPAC names are the same. For dihalogen derivatives, the prefix ortho, meta, para are used in common system, but in IUPAC system, as you have learnt in class 11, unit 12, the numerals 1, 2, 1, 3 and 1, 4 are used. Common name N-propyl bromide. IUPAC name 1-bromopropane. Common name isopropyl chloride. IUPAC name 2-chloropropane. Common name isobutyl chloride and IUPAC name 1-chloro-2-methylpropane. Common name bromobenzene, IUPAC name is also bromobenzene. Common name metadibromobenzene, IUPAC name 1,3-dibromobenzene. The dihaloalkanes having the same type of halogen atoms are named as alkylidene or alkylene dihalides. The dihalo compounds having both the halogen atoms are further classified as geminal halides or gem halides when both the halogen atoms are present on the same carbon atom of the chain, and vicinal halides or vis dihalides when halogen atoms are present on adjacent carbon atoms. In common name system, geminal dihalides are named as alkylidene halides and vicinal dihalides are named as alkylene dihalides. In IUPAC system, they are named as dihaloalkanes. Some common examples of halo compounds are mentioned in Table 10.1. Table 10.1, common in IUPAC name of some halides. 10.3, nature of carbon halogen bond. Halogen atoms are more electronegative than carbon, therefore carbon halogen bond of alkyl halide is polarized. The carbon atom bears a partial positive charge, whereas the halogen atom bears a partial negative charge. As we go down the group in the periodic table, the size of halogen atom increases. Fluorine atom is the smallest and iodine atom is the largest. Consequently, the carbon halogen bond length also increases from carbon fluorine to carbon iodine. Some typical bond lengths, bond enthalpies and dipole moments are given in Table 10.2. Alkyl halides are best prepared from alcohols, which are easily accessible. 10.2, Table 10.2, carbon halogen bond lengths, bond enthalpies and dipole moments. 10.4, methods of preparation of haloalkanes. 10.4.1, from alcohols. The hydroxyl group of an alcohol is replaced by halogen on reaction with concentrated halogen acids, phosphorus halides or thionyl chloride. Thionyl chloride is preferred because in this reaction alkyl halide is formed along with gases sulfur dioxide and hydrochloric acid. The two gaseous products are escapable, hence the reaction gives pure alkyl halides. The reactions of primary and secondary alcohols with HCl require the presence of a catalyst ZnCl2. With tertiary alcohols, the reaction is conducted by simply shaking the alcohol with concentrated HCl at room temperature. Constant boiling with HBr in briquette 48% is used for preparing alkyl bromide. Good yields of Ri may be obtained by heating alcohols with sodium or potassium iodide in 95% orthophosphoric acid. The order of reactivity of alcohols with a given halo acid is tertiary is greater than secondary is greater than primary. Phosphorus, tribromide and triiodide are usually generated in situ in bracket produced in the reaction mixture by the reaction of red phosphorus with bromine and iodine respectively. ROH plus HCl in presence of ZnCl2 will give you RCl plus H2O. ROH plus NaBr plus H2SO4 will form RBr plus NaHSO4 plus H2O. 3R OH plus PX3 will form 3RX plus H3PO3 where X is equals to Cl, Br. ROH plus PCl5 will form RCl plus POCl3 plus HCl. ROH in presence of red phosphorus / X2 where X2 is equals to Br2, I2 will form RX. ROH plus SOCl2 will form RCl plus SO2 plus HCl. The preparation of alkyl chloride is carried out either by passing dry hydrogen chloride gas through a solution of alcohol or by heating a mixture of alcohol and concentrated aqueous halogen acid. The above methods are not applicable for the preparation of aryl halides because the carbon-oxygen bond in phenols has a partial double bond character and is difficult to break, being stronger than a single bond. In bracket unit 11, class 11. 10.4.2 from hydrocarbons. First from alkanes by free radical halogenation. Free radical chlorination or bromination of alkanes gives a complex mixture of isomeric mono and polyhaloalkanes, which is difficult to separate as pure compounds. Consequently, the yield of any single compound is low. In bracket unit 13, class 11. CH3CH2CH2CH3 in presence of Cl2/UV light or heat will form CH3CH2CH2CH2Cl plus CH3CH2CHClCH3. Second, from alkenes. First, addition of hydrogen halides. An alkene is converted to corresponding alkyl halide by reaction with hydrogen chloride, hydrogen bromide or hydrogen iodide. Propene yields two products, however only one predominates as per Markovnikov's rule. In bracket unit 13, class 11. CH3CH double bond CH2 plus HI will form CH3CH2CH2I minor plus CH3CHICH3 major. Second, addition of halogens. In the laboratory, addition of bromine in CCl4 to an alkene resulting in discharge of reddish brown color of bromine constitutes an important method for the detection of double bond in a molecule. The addition results in the synthesis of vicinal dibromides, which are colorless. In bracket unit 13, class 11. This is ethene plus Br2 in presence of CCl4 form BrCH2CH2Br. This is vicinal dibromide. 10.4.3 halogen exchange. Alkyl iodides are often prepared by the reaction of alkyl chloride/bromides with NaI in dry acetone. This reaction is known as Finkelstein reaction. Rx plus NaI will form Ri plus NaX. NaCl or NaBr thus formed is precipitated in dry acetone. It facilitates the forward reaction according to Lee Chatelier's principle. The synthesis of alkyl chlorides is best accomplished by heating an alkyl chloride or bromide in the presence of a metallic fluoride such as AgF, Hg2F2, CoF2 or SbF3. The reaction is termed as Schwartz reaction. CH3Br plus AgF will form CH3F plus AgBr. 10.5 Preparation of haloarenes. First, from hydrocarbons by electrophilic substitution. Aryl chlorides and bromides can be easily prepared by electrophilic substitution of arenes with chlorine and bromine respectively in the presence of Lewis acid catalyst like iron or iron 3 chloride. The ortho and para isomers can be easily separated due to large difference in the melting points. Reactions with iodine are reversible in nature and require the presence of an oxidizing agent in bracket HNO3, HiO4 to oxidize the Hi formed during iodination. Fluoro compounds are not prepared by this method due to high reactivity of fluorine. Second, from amines by Sandmeyer's reaction. When a primary aromatic amine dissolved or suspended in cold aqueous mineral acid is treated with sodium nitrite, a diazonium salt is formed. In bracket unit 13, class 12. Mixing the solution of freshly prepared diazonium salt with cuprous chloride or cuprous bromide results in the replacement of the diazonium group by Cl or Br. Replacement of the diazonium group by iodine does not require the presence of cuprous halide and is done simply by shaking the diazonium salt with potassium iodide. 10.6 Physical properties. Alkyl halides are colorless when pure, however bromides and iodides develop color when exposed to light. Many volatile halogen compounds have sweet smell. Melting and boiling points. Methyl chloride, methyl bromide, ethyl chloride and some chlorofluoromethanes are gases at room temperature. Higher members are liquids or solids. As we have already learned, molecules of organic halogen compounds are generally polar. Due to greater polarity as well as higher molecular mass as compared to the parent hydrocarbon, the intermolecular forces of attraction in bracket dipole-dipole and van der Waals are stronger in the halogen derivatives. That is why the boiling points of chlorides, bromides, and iodides are considerably higher than those of the hydrocarbons of comparable molecular mass. The attraction gets stronger as the molecules get bigger in size and have more electrons. The pattern of variation of boiling points of different halides is depicted in figure 10.1. For the same alkyl group, the boiling points of alkyl halides decrease in the order Ri greater than RBr, greater than RCl, greater than RF. This is because with the increase in size and mass of halogen atom, the magnitude of van der Waals forces increases. The boiling point of isomeric haloalkanes decrease with increase in branching. In bracket unit 12, class 11. For example, 2-bromo-2-methylpropane has the lowest boiling point among the three isomers. Boiling points of isomeric dihalobenzenes are very nearly the same. However, the para isomers are high melting as compared to their ortho and meta isomers. It is due to symmetry of para isomers that fits in crystal lattice better as compared to ortho and meta isomers. Density. Bromo, iodo and polychloro derivatives of hydrocarbons are heavier than water. The density increases with increase in number of carbon atoms, halogen atoms and atomic mass of the halogen atoms. In bracket, table 10.3. Table 10.3, density of some haloalkanes. Solubility. The haloalkanes are very slightly soluble in water. In order to dissolve haloalkane in water, energy is required to overcome the attractions between the haloalkane molecules and break the hydrogen bonds between water molecules. Less energy is released when new attractions are set up between the haloalkane and the water molecules, as these are not as strong as the original hydrogen bonds in water. As a result, the solubility of haloalkanes in water is low. However, haloalkanes tend to dissolve in organic solvents because the new intermolecular attractions between haloalkanes and solvent molecules have much the same strength as the ones being broken in the separate haloalkane and solvent molecules. 10.7 Chemical reactions. The reactions of haloalkanes may be divided into the following categories. First, nucleophilic substitution. Second, elimination reactions. Third, reaction with metals. 10.7.1 Reactions of haloalkanes. First, nucleophilic substitution reactions. You have learned in class 11 that nucleophiles are electron-rich species. Therefore, they attack at the part of the substrate molecule which is electron-deficient. The reaction in which a nucleophile replaces already existing nucleophile in a molecule is called nucleophilic substitution reaction. Haloalkanes are substrate in these reactions. In this type of reaction, a nucleophile reacts with haloalkane, in bracket the substrate, having a partial positive charge on the carbon atom bonded to halogen. A substitution reaction takes place and halogen atom fold leaving group departs as halide ion. Since the substitution reaction is initiated by a nucleophile, it is called nucleophilic substitution reaction. It is one of the most useful classes of organic reactions of alkyl halides in which halogen is bonded to sp3 hybridized carbon. The products formed by the reaction of haloalkanes with some common nucleophiles are given in table 10.4. Table 10.4, nucleophilic substitution of alkyl halides. Groups like cyanides and nitrites possess two nucleophilic centers and are called ambivalent nucleophiles. Actually, cyanide group is a hybrid of two contributing structures and therefore can act as a nucleophile in two different ways, that is linking through carbon atom resulting in alkyl cyanides and through nitrogen atom leading to isocyanides. Similarly, nitrite ion also represents the ambivalent nucleophile with two different points of linkage. The linkage through oxygen results in alkyl nitrites, while through nitrogen atom it leads to nitroalkanes. Mechanism. This reaction has been found to proceed by two different mechanisms which are described below. A. Substitution nucleophilic bimolecular, in bracket SN2. The reaction between CH3Cl and hydroxide ion to yield methanol and chloride ion follows a second order kinetics. That is, the rate depends upon the concentration of both the reactants. You have already learnt in section 12.3.2 of class 11. The solid wedge represents the bond coming out of the paper dashed line going down the paper and a straight line representing bond in the plane of the paper. The above reaction can be represented diagrammatically as shown in figure 10.2. Figure 10.2, red ball represents the incoming hydroxide ion and green ball represents the outgoing halide ion. In the year 1937, Edward Davis Hughes and Sir Christopher Ingold proposed a mechanism for an SN2 reaction. It depicts a biomolecular nucleophilic substitution, SN2 reaction. The incoming nucleophile interacts with alkyl halide, causing the carbon halide bond to break, and a new bond is formed between carbon and attacking nucleophile. Here, it is carbon-oxygen bond formed between carbon and OH. These two processes take place simultaneously in a single step and no intermediate is formed. As the reaction progresses and the bond between the incoming nucleophile and the carbon atom start forming, the bond between carbon atom and leaving group weakens. As this happens, the three carbon hydrogen bonds of the substrate start moving away from the attacking nucleophile. In transition state, all the three carbon hydrogen bonds are in the same plane and the attacking and leaving nucleophiles are partially attached to the carbon. As the attacking nucleophile approach closer to the carbon, carbon-hydrogen bonds still keep on moving in the same direction till the attacking nucleophile attached to the carbon and leaving group leaves the carbon. As a result, configuration is inverted. The configuration, in bracket C box, of carbon atom under attack inverts in much the same way as an umbrella is turned inside out when caught in a strong wind. This process is called as inversion of configuration. In the transition state, the carbon atom is simultaneously bonded to incoming nucleophile and the outgoing leaving group. Such structures are unstable and cannot be isolated. Thus, in the transition state, carbon is simultaneously bonded to 5 atoms. Configuration. Spatial arrangement of functional groups around carbon is called its configuration. See the structure A and B given below carefully. These are the two structures of the same compound. They differ in spatial arrangement of functional groups attached to carbon. Structure A is mirror image of structure B. We say the configuration of carbon in structure A is mirror image of the configuration of carbon in structure B. Hughes worked under Ingold and earned a DSc degree from the University of London. Since this reaction requires the approach of the nucleophile to the carbon bearing the leaving group, the presence of bulky substituents on or near the carbon atom have a dramatic inhibiting effect. Of the simple alkyl halides, methyl halides react most rapidly in SN2 reactions because there are only three small hydrogen atoms. Tertiary halides are the least reactive because bulky groups hinder the approaching nucleophiles. Thus, the order of reactivity followed is primary halide is greater than secondary halide is greater than tertiary halide. Figure 10.3, steric effects in SN2 reaction. The relative rate of SN2 reaction is given in parentheses. B, substitution nucleophilic unimolecular in bracket SN1. SN1 reactions are generally carried out in polar protic solvents in bracket like water, alcohol, acetic acid, etc. The reaction between tert butyl bromide and hydroxide ion yields tert butyl alcohol and follows the first order kinetics, that is, the rate of reaction depends upon the concentration of only one reactant, which is tert butyl bromide. 2-bromo-2-methylpropane plus OH minus will form 2-methylpropane-2-ol plus Br minus ion. It occurs in two steps. In step 1, the polarized carbon Br bond undergoes slow cleavage to produce a carbocation and a bromide ion. The carbocation thus formed is then attacked by nucleophile in step 2 to complete the substitution reaction. Step 1 is the slowest and reversible. It involves the carbon-bromine bond breaking, for which the energy is obtained through solvation of halide ion with the proton of protic solvent. Since the rate of reaction depends upon the slowest step, the rate of reaction depends only on the concentration of alkyl halide and not on the concentration of hydroxide ion. Further, greater the stability of carbocation, greater will be its ease of formation from alkyl halide and faster will be the rate of reaction. In case of alkyl halides, tertiary alkyl halides undergo SN1 reaction very fast because of the high stability of tertiary carbocations. We can sum up the order of reactivity of alkyl halides towards SN1 and SN2 reactions as follows. For the same reasons, allylic and benzylic halides show high reactivity towards the SN1 reaction. The carbocation thus formed gets stabilized through resonance in bracket unit 12 class 11 as shown below. For a given alkyl group, the reactivity of the halide Rx follow the same order in both the mechanism Ri greater than RBr greater than RCl greater than Rf. See stereochemical aspects of nucleophilic substitution reactions. In order to understand the stereochemical aspects of substitution reactions, we need to learn some basic stereochemical principles and notations. In bracket, optical activity, chirality, retention, inversion, racemization, etc. William Nicol, in bracket 1768 to 1851, developed the first prism that produced plane polarized light. First, optical activity. Plane of plane polarized light produced by passing ordinary light through Nicol prism is rotated when it passed through the solutions of certain compounds. Such compounds are called optically active compounds. The angle by which the plane polarized light is rotated is measured by an instrument called polarimeter. If the compound rotates the plane of plane polarized light to the right, that is clockwise direction, it is called dextrorotatory. In bracket Greek for right rotating, or the D form N is indicated by placing a positive plus sign before the degree of rotation. If the light is rotated towards left, in bracket anti-clockwise direction, the compound is said to be levorotatory, or the L form, and a negative sign is placed before the degree of rotation. Such plus and minus isomers of a compound are called optical isomers, and the phenomenon is termed as optical isomerism. Second, molecular asymmetry, chirality, and enantiomers. The observation of Louis Pasteur in bracket 1848 that crystals of certain compounds exist in the form of mirror images laid the foundation of modern stereochemistry. He demonstrated that aqueous solutions of both types of crystals show optical rotation equal in magnitude, in bracket, for solution of equal concentration but opposite in direction. He believed that this difference in optical activity was associated with the three-dimensional arrangements of atoms in the molecules, in bracket, configurations of two types of crystals. Dutch scientist J. Bonthoff and French scientist C. Lebel in the same year, in bracket 1874, independently argued that the spatial arrangement of four groups in bracket valencies around the central carbon is tetrahedral, and if all the substituents attached to that carbon are different, the mirror image of the molecule is not superimposed, in bracket overlap on the molecule, such as carbon is called asymmetric carbon or stereocenter. The resulting molecule would lack symmetry and is referred to as asymmetric molecule. The asymmetry of the molecule along with known superimposability of mirror images is responsible for the optical activity in such organic compounds. Jacobus Hendrikus Wontoff in bracket 1852 to 1911 received the first Nobel Prize in Chemistry in 1901 for his work on solutions. The symmetry and asymmetry are also observed in many day-to-day objects. A sphere, a cube, a cone are all identical to their mirror images and can be superimposed. However, many objects are known superimposable on their mirror images. For example, your left and right hand look similar, but if you put your left hand on your right hand by moving them in the same plane, they do not coincide. The objects which are known superimposable on the mirror image, in bracket like a pair of hands, are said to be chiral, and this property is known as chirality. Chiral molecules are optically active, while the objects which are superimposable on the mirror images are called achiral. These molecules are optically inactive. The above test of molecular chirality can be applied to organic molecules by constructing models and its mirror images, or by drawing three-dimensional structures and attempting to superimpose them in our hand, in our minds. There are other aids, however, that can assist us in recognizing chiral molecules. One such aid is the presence of a single asymmetric carbon atom. Let us consider two simple molecules, propane-2-ol in bracket figure 10.5 and butane-2-ol in bracket figure 10.6 and their mirror images. As you can see very clearly, propane-2-ol in bracket A does not contain an asymmetric carbon as all the four groups attached to the tetrahedral carbon are not different. We rotate the mirror image in bracket B of the molecule by 180 degree in bracket structure C and try to overlap the structure C with the structure A. The structures completely overlap. Thus, propane-2-ol is an achiral molecule. Butane-2-ol has four different groups attached to the tetrahedral carbon and is expected as is chiral. Some common examples of chiral molecules such as 2-chlorobutane, 2,3-dihydroxypropanol, bromochloroiodomethane, 2-bromopropanoic acid, etc. The stereoisomers related to each other as known superimposable mirror images are called enantiomers. A and B in figure 10.5 and D and E in figure 10.6 are enantiomers. Enantiomers possess identical physical properties, namely melting point, boiling point, refractive index, etc. They only differ with respect to the rotation of plane polarized light. If one of the enantiomers is dextrorotatory, the other will be levorotatory. However, the sign of optical rotation is not necessarily related to the absolute configuration of the molecule. A mixture containing two enantiomers in equal proportions will have zero optical rotation, as the rotation due to one isomer will be cancelled by the rotation due to the other isomer. Such a mixture is known as racemic mixture or racemic modification. A racemic mixture is represented by prefixing DL or plus minus before the name. For example, plus minus butane-2-ol. The process of conversion of enantiomer into a racemic mixture is known as racemization. Third, retention. Retention of configuration is the preservation of the spatial arrangement of bonds to an asymmetric center during a chemical reaction or transformation. In general, if during a reaction no bond to the stereo center is broken, the product will have the same general configuration of groups around the stereo center as that of reactant. Such a reaction is said to proceed with retention of the configuration. Consider as an example the reaction that takes place when minus 2-methylbutane-1-ol is heated with concentrated hydrochloric acid. It is important to note that configuration at a symmetric center in the reactant and product is same, but the sign of optical rotation has changed in the product. This is so because two different compounds with same configuration at asymmetric center may have different optical rotation. One may be dextrorotatory in bracket plus sign of optical rotation, while other may be levorotatory in bracket negative sign of optical rotation. Fourth, inversion, retention and racemization. There are three outcomes for a reaction at an asymmetric carbon atom when a bond directly linked to an asymmetric carbon atom is broken. Consider the replacement of a group X by Y in the following reaction. If A is the only compound obtained, the process is called retention of configuration. Note that configuration has been rotated in A. If B is the only compound obtained, the process is called inversion of configuration. Configuration has been inverted in B. If a 50-50 mixture of A and B is obtained, then the process is called racemization and the product is optically inactive as one isomer will rotate the plane polarized light in the direction opposite to another. Now let us have a fresh look at SN1 and SN2 mechanism by taking examples of optically active alkyl halides. In case of optically active alkyl halides, the product formed as a result of SN2 mechanism has the inverted configuration as compared to the reactant. This is because the nucleophile attaches itself on the side opposite to the one where the halogen atom is present. When plus 2 bromo octane is allowed to react with sodium hydroxide, plus octane 2-ol is formed with the OH group occupying the position opposite to what bromide had occupied. Thus, SN2 reactions of optically active halides are accompanied by inversion of configuration. In case of optically active alkyl halides, SN1 reactions are accompanied by racemization. Can you think the reason why it happens? Actually, the carbocation formed in the slow step being sp2 hybridized is planar, in bracket a chiral. The attack of the nucleophile may be accomplished from either side of the plane of carbocation, resulting in a mixture of products, one having the same configuration, in bracket the OH attaching on the same position as halide ion, and the other having opposite configuration, in bracket the OH attaching on the side opposite to halide ion. This may be illustrated by hydrolysis of optically active 2-bromobutane, which results in the formation of plus minus butane 2-ol. Location of alpha and beta carbon in a molecule. Carbon on which halogen atom is directly attached is called alpha carbon, and the carbon atom adjacent to this carbon is called beta carbon. Second reaction, elimination reactions. When a haloalkane with beta hydrogen atom is heated with alcoholic solution of potassium hydroxide, there is elimination of hydrogen atom from beta carbon and a halogen atom from the alpha carbon atom. As a result, an alkene is formed as a product. Since beta hydrogen atom is involved in elimination, it is often called beta elimination. If there is possibility of formation of more than one alkene due to the availability of more than one beta hydrogen atoms, usually one alkene is formed as the major product. This formed part of a pattern first observed by Russian chemist Alexander Zaitsev, in bracket also pronounced as Zaitsev, who in 1875 formulated a rule which can be summarized as, in dehydrohalogenation reactions, the preferred product is that alkene which has greater number of alkyl groups attached to the doubly bonded carbon atoms. Thus, 2-bromopentane gives pent-2-ene as the major product. Pent-2-ene 81%, 2-bromopentane and pent-1-ene 19%. Elimination versus substitution. A chemical reaction is the result of competition. It is a race that is won by the fastest runner. A collection of molecules tend to do, by and large, what is easiest for them. An alkyl halide with beta hydrogen atoms, when reacted with a base or a nucleophile, has two competing routes, substitution, in bracket SN1 and SN2, and elimination. Which route will be taken up depends upon the nature of alkyl halide, strength and size of base / nucleophile, and reaction conditions. Thus, a bulkier nucleophile will prefer to act as a base and abstracts a proton rather than approaches a tetravalent carbon atom, in bracket steric reasons, and vice versa. Similarly, a primary alkyl halide will prefer a SN2 reaction, a secondary halide SN2, or elimination depending upon the strength of base / nucleophile, and a tertiary halide SN1 or elimination depending upon the stability of carbocation or the more substituted alkene. Third reaction with metals. Most organic chlorides, bromides, and iodides react with certain metals to give compounds containing carbon metal bonds. Such compounds are known as organometallic compounds. An important class of organometallic compounds discovered by Victor Grignard in 1900 in alkyl magnesium halide, RMGX, referred as Grignard reagents. These reagents are obtained by the reaction of haloalkenes with magnesium metal in dry ether. CH3CH2Br plus Mg in presence of dry ether will form Grignard reagent. Victor Grignard had a strange start in academic life for a chemist. He took a maths degree. When he eventually switched to chemistry, it was not to the mathematical province of physical chemistry but to organic chemistry. While attempting to find an efficient catalyst for the process of methylation, he noted that zinc in diethyl ether had been used for this purpose and wondered whether the magnesium or ether combination might be successful. Grignard reagents were first reported in 1900, and Grignard used this work for his doctoral thesis in 1901. In 1910, Grignard obtained a professorship at the University of Nancy, and in 1912, he was awarded the Nobel Prize for Chemistry, which he shared with Paul Sachter, who had made advances in nickel-catalyzed hydrogenation. In the Grignard reagent, the carbon-magnesium bond is covalent but highly polar, with carbon pulling electrons from electropositive magnesium. The magnesium-halogen bond is essentially ionic. Grignard reagents are highly reactive and react with any source of proton to give hydrocarbons. Even water, alcohols, amines are sufficiently acidic to convert them to corresponding hydrocarbons. It is therefore necessary to avoid even traces of moisture from a Grignard reagent. That is why reaction is carried out in dry ether. On the other hand, this could be considered as one of the methods for converting halides to hydrocarbons. Wood's reaction. Alkyl halides react with sodium in dry ether to give hydrocarbons containing double the number of carbon atoms present in the halide. This reaction is known as Wood's reaction. In bracket, unit 13, class 11. 2Rx plus 2Na will form Rr plus 2NaX. 10.7.2 Reactions of haloarenes. First, nucleophilic substitution. Aryl halides are extremely less reactive towards nucleophilic substitution reactions due to the following reasons. First, resonance effect. In haloarenes, the electron pairs on halogen atom are in conjugation with pi electrons of the ring, and the following resonating structures are possible. Carbon-chlorine bond acquires a partial double bond character due to resonance. As a result, the bond cleavage in haloarene is difficult than haloalkane, and therefore they are less reactive towards nucleophilic substitution reaction. Second, difference in hybridization of carbon atom in carbon-halogen bond. In haloalkane, the carbon atom attached to halogen in sp3 hybridized, while in case of haloarene, the carbon atom attached to halogen is sp2 hybridized. The sp2 hybridized carbon with a greater s character is more electronegative and can hold the electron pair of carbon-halogen bond more tightly than sp3 hybridized carbon in haloalkane with less s character. Thus, carbon-chlorine bond length in haloalkane is 177 picometer, while in haloarene is 169 picometer. Since it is difficult to break a shorter bond than a longer bond, therefore haloarenes are less reactive than haloalkanes towards nucleophilic substitution reaction. Third, instability of phenyl cation. In case of haloarenes, the phenyl cation formed as a result of self ionization will not be stabilized by resonance, and therefore SN1 mechanism is ruled out. Fourth, because of the possible repulsion, it is less likely for the electron-rich nucleophile to approach electron-rich arenes. Replacement by hydroxyl group. Chlorobenzene can be converted into phenol by heating in aqueous sodium hydroxide solution at a temperature of 623 Kelvin and a pressure of 300 atmosphere. The presence of an electron withdrawing group in bracket NO2 at ortho and para positions increases the reactivity of haloarenes. The effect is pronounced when in bracket NO2 group is introduced at ortho and para positions. However, no effect on reactivity of haloarenes is observed by the presence of electron withdrawing group at metaposition. Mechanism of the reaction is as depicted. Can you think why does NO2 group show its effect only at ortho and para positions and not at metaposition? As shown, the presence of nitro group at ortho and para positions withdraws the electron density from the benzene ring and thus facilitate the attack of the nucleophile on haloarene. The carb anion thus formed is stabilized through resonance. The negative charge appeared at ortho and para positions with respect to the halogen substituent is stabilized by NO2 group, while in case of metanitrobenzene, none of the resonating structures bear the negative charge on carbon atom bearing the NO2 group. Therefore, the presence of nitro group at metaposition does not stabilize the negative charge, and no effect on reactivity is observed by the presence of NO2 group at metaposition. Second, electrophilic substitution reactions. Halogens undergo the usual electrophilic reactions of the benzene ring, such as halogenation, nitration, sulfonation, and Friedel-Crafts reactions. Halogen atom, besides being slightly deactivating, is ortho-para-directing. Therefore, further substitution occurs at ortho and para positions with respect to the halogen atom. The ortho-para-directing influence of halogen atom can be easily understood if we consider the resonating structures of halobenzene as shown. Due to resonance, the electron density increases more at ortho and para positions than at meta positions. Further, the halogen atom, because of its I effect, has some tendency to withdraw electrons from the benzene ring. As a result, the ring gets somewhat deactivated as compared to benzene, and hence the electrophilic substitution reactions in halogens occur slowly and require more drastic conditions as compared to those in benzene. First, halogenation. Chlorobenzene plus Cl2 in presence of anhydrous FeCl3 will form 1,4-dichlorobenzene major plus 1,2-dichlorobenzene minor. Second, nitration. Chlorobenzene in presence of HNO3 and concentrated H2SO4 will form 1-chloro-2-nitrobenzene minor plus 1-chloro-4-nitrobenzene major. Third, sulfonation. Chlorobenzene in presence of heat and concentrated H2SO4 will form 2-chlorobenzene sulfonic acid minor plus 4-chlorobenzene sulfonic acid major. Fourth, Friedel-Crafts reaction. Chlorobenzene plus CH3Cl in presence of anhydrous AlCl3 will form 1-chloro-2-methylbenzene minor plus 1-chloro-4-methylbenzene major. Chlorobenzene plus CH3COCl in presence of anhydrous AlCl3 will form 2-chloroacetophenone minor plus 4-chloroacetophenone major. Third, reaction with metals. Wood's-Wittig reaction. A mixture of an alkyl halide and aryl halide gives an alkyl arene when treated with sodium in dry ether and is called Wood's-Wittig reaction. Halobenzene plus Na plus Rx in presence of dry ether will form this one plus NaX. Wittig reaction. Aryl halides also gives analogous compound when treated with sodium in dry ether, in which two aryl groups are joined together. It is called Wittig reaction. 10.8 Polyhalogen compounds. Carbon compounds containing more than one halogen atom are usually referred to as polyhalogen compounds. Many of these compounds are useful in industry and agriculture. Some polyhalogen compounds are described in this section. 10.8.1 Dichloromethane in bracket methylene chloride. Dichloromethane is widely used as a solvent, as a paint remover, as a propellant in aerosols, and as a process solvent in the manufacture of drugs. It is also used as a metal cleaning and finishing solvent. Methylene chloride harms the human central nervous system. Exposure to lower levels of methylene chloride in air can lead to slightly impaired hearing and vision. Higher levels of methylene chloride in air cause dizziness, nausea, tingling and numbness in the fingers and toes. In humans, direct skin contact with methylene chloride causes intense burning and mild redness of the skin. Direct contact with the eyes can burn the cornea. 10.8.2 Trichloromethane in bracket chloroform. Chemically, chloroform is employed as a solvent for fats, alkaloids, iodine, and other substances. The major use of chloroform today is in the production of the freon refrigerant R22. It was once used as a general anesthetic in surgery but has been replaced by less toxic, safer anesthetics such as ether. As might be expected from its use as an anesthetic, inhaling chloroform vapors depress the central nervous system. breathing about 900 parts of chloroform per million parts of air, in bracket 900 parts per million, for a short time can cause dizziness, fatigue and headache. Chronic chloroform exposure may cause damage to the liver, in bracket where chloroform is metabolized to FOS gene, and to the kidneys, and some people develop sores when the skin is immersed in chloroform. Chloroform is slowly oxidized by air in the presence of light to an extremely poisonous gas, carbonyl fluoride, also known as FOS gene. It is therefore stored in closed, dark colored bottles, completely filled so that air is kept out. 2CHCl3 plus O2 in presence of light will form 2COCl2, that is FOS gene plus 2HCl. 10.8.3 triiodomethane in bracket iodoform. It was used earlier as an antiseptic, but the antiseptic properties are due to the liberation of free iodine and not due to iodoform itself. Due to its objectionable smell, it has been replaced by other formulations containing iodine. 10.8.4 tetrachloromethane in bracket carbon tetrachloride. It is produced in large quantities for us in the manufacture of refrigerants and propellants for aerosol cans. It is also used as feedstock in the synthesis of chlorofluorocarbons and other chemicals, pharmaceutical manufacturing and general solvent use. Until the mid-1960s, it was also widely used as a cleaning fluid both in industry as a degreasing agent and in the home as a spot remover and as fire extinguisher. There is some evidence that exposure to carbon tetrachloride causes liver cancer in humans. The most common effects are dizziness, lightheadedness, nausea and vomiting, which can cause permanent damage to nerve cells. In severe cases, these effects can lead rapidly to stupor, coma, unconsciousness or death. Exposure to carbon tetrachloride can make the heartbeat irregularly or stop. The chemical may irritate the eyes on contact. When carbon tetrachloride is released into the air, it rises to the atmosphere and depletes the ozone layer. Depletion of the ozone layer is believed to increase human exposure to ultraviolet rays, leading to increased skin cancer, eye diseases and disorders, and possible disruption of the immune system. 10.8.5 Freons. The chlorofluorocarbon compounds of methane and ethane are collectively known as freons. They are extremely stable, unreactive, non-toxic, non-corrosive and easily liquefiable gases. Freon 12 in bracket CCl2F2 is one of the most common freons in industrial use. It is manufactured from tetrachloromethane by Schwartz reaction. These are usually produced for aerosol propellants, refrigeration and air conditioning purposes. By 1974, total freon production in the world was about 2 billion pounds annually. Most freon, even that used in refrigeration, eventually makes its way into the atmosphere where it diffuses unchanged into the stratosphere. In stratosphere, freon is able to initiate radical chain reactions that can upset the natural ozone balance. In bracket unit 14 class 11. 10.8.6 dichlorodiphenyltrichloroethane in bracket DDT. DDT, the first chlorinated organic insecticide, was originally prepared in 1873, but it was not until 1939 that Paul Muller of Geigy Pharmaceuticals in Switzerland discovered the effectiveness of DDT as an insecticide. Paul Muller was awarded the Nobel Prize in Medicine and Physiology in 1948 for this discovery. The use of DDT increased enormously on a worldwide basis after World War II, primarily because of its effectiveness against the mosquito that spreads malaria and lice that carries typhus. However, problems related to extensive use of DDT began to appear in the late 1940s. Many species of insects developed resistance to DDT, and it was also discovered to have high toxicity towards fish. The chemical stability of DDT and its fat solubility compounded the problem. DDT is not metabolized very rapidly by animals. Instead, it is deposited and stored in the fatty tissues. If ingestion continues at a steady rate, DDT builds up within the animals over time. The use of DDT was banned in the United States in 1973, although it is still in use in some other parts of the world. Summary: alkyl/aryl halides may be classified as mono, di, or polyhalogen in bracket, tri, tetra, etc. compounds depending on whether they contain one, two, or more halogen atoms in their structures. Since halogen atoms are more electronegative than carbon, the carbon-halogen bond of alkyl halide is polarized. The carbon atom bears a partial positive charge and the halogen atom bears a partial negative charge. Alkyl halides are prepared by the free radical halogenation of alkanes, addition of halogen acids to alkenes, replacement of OH group of alcohols with halogens using phosphorus halides, thionyl chloride, or halogen acids. Aryl halides are prepared by electrophilic substitution to aryls. Fluorides and iodides are best prepared by halogen exchange method. The boiling points of organohalogen compounds are comparatively higher than the corresponding hydrocarbons because of strong dipole-dipole and van der Waals forces of attraction. These are slightly soluble in water but completely soluble in organic solvents. The polarity of carbon-halogen bond of alkyl halides is responsible for their nucleophilic substitution, elimination, and the reaction with metal atoms to form organometallic compounds. Nucleophilic substitution reactions are categorized into SN1 and SN2 on the basis of their kinetic properties. Chirality has a profound role in understanding the reaction mechanisms of SN1 and SN2 reactions. SN2 reactions of chiral alkyl halides are characterized by the inversion of configuration, while SN1 reactions are characterized by racemization. A number of polyhalogen compounds, for example dichloromethane, chloroform, iodoform, carbon tetrachloride, freon, and DDT, have many industrial applications. However, some of these compounds cannot be easily decomposed and even cause depletion of ozone layer and are proving environmental hazards.